The LMG's gotta be the least used weapon class in the game, so if you're looking for specific tips, timestamps will be in the description below. There are 4 LMGs in total to complete: the M91, PKM, MG34, and the SA87. The Holger 26 and the MK9 Bruin are not required for Platinum or Damascus because they are DLC guns. Here's the order I recommend for the best experience while completing the LMGs. This is based on how much fun I had with the guns in order from least fun to most. If you're still having a hard time deciding on what LMG to use first, here's a quick rundown of each gun. The PKM is the most accurate of the LMGs, coupled with the highest damage output, makes for a very lethal weapon. Its downsides are it's the worst LMG in recoil and range, but it's not too far behind the others. It's also tied for the slowest reload time of the LMGs with a 9.13 second reload time. The SA-87 plays more like an AR, even using the 5.56 rounds like an AR, making its prey more consistent and giving it less recoil than its LMG counterparts. Its downsides being the lower fire rate and magazine size. It also has the best mobility and the fastest reload speed out of the LMGs, only taking 3.35 seconds. The M91 is the most balanced of the LMGs, only lagging very slightly behind in damage output. In my opinion, this weapon feels the most like an LMG and looks the coolest out of the bunch. It also has a 7 second reload time. The MG34 is the best LMG statistically, having the longest range, fastest fire rate, while being the easiest LMG to control. This does come at a cost, being the slowest and most inaccurate LMG. Its reload time is tied for the slowest at 9.13 seconds. I've also put together an easier to read stat sheet for the LMGs, with the yellow dot marking the best stat of the group while the white dot marking the worst. A lot of the time when I'm trying to develop a playstyle for a gun, I look at what holds it back the most. In the case of the LMGs, its slow movement, sprint to fire, and ADS speeds are some of its biggest weaknesses. To counter this, I'll build all my LMGs to boost hip fire accuracy, aim stability, and magazine capacity. Then I literally just walk and shoot. It's actually that simple. But if you want to spice it up a bit, you can pre-fire common angles, objectives, doorways, or literally just shoot in any direction, you'll probably end up with a kill. Also, the LMGs can wallbang very easily. To wallbang more effectively, shoot through thin structures like wood or the corners of walls. Hardcore makes completing challenges a lot easier, especially if you hop in the best playlist for grinding that's usually named something dumb like Rusty Houseboat. But all you need to know is that Rust, Shoot House, and Shipment are in rotation. But just a little heads up, this rotation heavily leans towards Rust and Shoot House over Shipment, so try to manage your map expectations accordingly. Really quick, here's some things to try to focus on for each of those three maps. On Rust, try to go for long shots and mounted kills. There's a very good mounted spot located here on the map that you can easily kill enemies crossing between the tanker and this building here. To get more consistent kills in this spot, in a domination game, capture both A and C, but leave the other team with the B flag for a solid spawn trap. Shoot House has a little something for everyone when it comes to grinding. You can walk around the outer areas of the map and rack up kills on people trying to flank, or set up on either one of the spawn walls for mounted and long shot kills. Shipment is good for almost any challenge besides long shots. I usually try to focus on getting crouching kills out of the way. Or I just walk around spraying, racking up kills. As always, if you have any specific questions, please leave them in the comments below, and I'll try to get to as many of them as I can. Also, if you have any tips that I haven't mentioned, be sure to leave them there as well. Now onto the camos. For spray paint, you're gonna need to kill 525 enemies. This is a mindless passive camo that you can lock by just using the gun. Difficulty?
Now forget about it.
For woodland, you need to get 75 headshots. Honestly, if you're just spraying with the LMG like I do, you'll slip and fall into a few headshots. But if you're still struggling, focusing on getting a few per game as well as practicing better crosshair placement will get you more headshots. Difficulty? Easy. Digital requires you to get 65 kills while crouching. This has always been the challenge I forget about the most, but 65 kills is easy as hell. A game or two of duck walking on shipment should do it for this challenge. Difficulty? For dragon, you need to get 45 hipfire kills. You won't get an easier challenge than this. Hipfire is already godlike on the LMGs when maxed out. Combined with the smaller map and hardcore will make this challenge fly by. Difficulty? Schmeet. For Splinter, you're going to need to get 45 long shot kills. Hardcore makes it easier for killing enemies at a longer distance. Also, playing around the outsides on Rust and mid on Shoot House are your best for knocking out long shots quickly. Difficulty? Not too bad. Topo requires you to get 45 mounted kills. I hate mounted kills as much as the next guy, but 45 kills is very reasonable. Mid on Shoot House and the spot I mentioned earlier under the pipe on Rust are both very good for mounted kills. Difficulty? All the homies hate mounted kills. Tiger requires you to get 180 kills with all attachments. This is a cakewalk, just tear through people with your decked out LMG. In case you're having a hard time putting together a build, here are a few of mine. Difficulty? Brain dead. For stripes, you need to get 30 double kills. Smaller maps and hardcore are always key to these multi-kill type challenges. But to get it done faster, after you get a kill, just keep shooting if you have the extra ammo. And a lot of the time I've found, people just walk right into it. Difficulty? Tough. For reptile, you need to get 75 kills with no attachments. This is one of the more difficult challenges because without any attachments, the LMGs just feel slow and sluggish. For this, I recommend hardcore as usual, as well as pre-firing with hipfire to sneak a few kills out. difficulty, frustrating. For his goals, you need to kill 3 enemies without dying 25 times. Same thing applies from the Stripes camo, but you get to play a little more cautious and slow. I got this camo done fast by spraying around on shipment. Difficulty? Pretty eh. That's all the tips I have for completing the LMG challenges. If any of this helped you, leave a like. If not, dislike. Also, if you're in the 95% of my viewers that aren't subscribed, please consider doing so. I try to put out a variety of content a few times a week, and subscribing helps the channel grow. Speaking of which, the support on the channel has been insane, and I just want to thank each and every one of you for it. It's incredible. If you made it all the way to the end of the video, go ahead and drop a less than 3 in the comments below. Peace.